for me is the wildness of the wildlife and just how primeval some of these sites are. Especially on this island here, on Lagoon Island, it's probably the only place in the world I've felt like an alien in another world, where as a human, you know, I shouldn't be here. I've got two young children, and ideally I'd love them to see Antarctica as it is.
I'm working on what lives at depth round here. The thing that's really kind of surprised me is like just how much life there is down here, and maybe just how variable it is. Like I've been down here for 2.5 years and I still probably couldn't tell you what a normal season is. It's, yeah, it's completely like bizarre and odd all the time, which is, I guess, part of the joy of being down here.
The landscape looks awe-inspiring, amazing, but in many places this is a system in turmoil, very dynamic and changing. We're seeing huge changes in the coastline that's retreating at a rapid rate over many areas of Antarctica, and especially here in the Antarctic Peninsula. And that gives us a problem when we're mapping, because we're continually having to update the coastline now. Whereas before we might have to draw the maps once every 20 years, now we're having to update them on an almost annual basis, which is quite a task. Antarctica is a huge continent, and conditions around it vary. But what scientists have started to realise over the last few years is that it's less stable than we previously thought. And that is a problem, because if even a small fraction of that huge ice sheet collapses into the sea, it will raise global sea levels, which could affect millions of people in coastal cities and small islands around the world.
When that last ship leaves at the end of the summer, you can look around and you've got 20 or so of your colleagues standing around you, and that's it. That's where you're getting everything from for the next 6 months of your life. That's your professional support, your emotional support, your emergency services, your whole social circle are there.
On top of being a chef, you're also the morale officer. It's critical that we think about everything before we get that order in, because once that ship arrives in Antarctica, that's it for the year. Whether we like it or not, that's all we've got to work with.
The strangest thing about being a doctor in Antarctica is the non-doctor things that we do. The souvenir shop, of course the doctor runs the souvenir shop. We have lots of t-shirts and mugs and postcards. And postcards need stamps, so we run the post office as well.